two black holes are orbiting each other. And as they orbit each other, they're emitting essentially a sine wave at some frequency. They're losing energy by emitting gravitational waves. And as they lose energy, they get closer together. They move faster. And you're at a higher frequency. And then, as you lose more and more energy, you get closer and closer together, and the black holes are orbiting faster and faster and faster, and emitting higher and higher frequency gravitational waves until they finally smash together. And what you get is... like that. We detected them. By the time gravitational waves from very massive objects reach us, they're very weak. How weak? Detecting it would require the most sensitive measuring device you could ever possibly imagine building. That's what LIGO is. L-I-G-O stands for the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory. Means we use lasers, powerful lasers, and we use the interference of the laser light to measure the way in which space and time warps as gravitational waves pass through our detectors.
Simple analogy is if you throw a rock in a still pond and you see the ripples going out. So as a wave comes through, it actually is stretching in one direction, contracting in the other, and then it goes back and forth by a really, really small amount.
I'm making gravitational waves right now as I wave my arms up and down. And in fact, everybody is all the time.
So the computing challenge we have is to pick out this really faint signal in a lot of noise. And it's very much analogous to, say, one submarine listening for another submarine in the ocean that's trying to be quiet with a lot of microphones. It's picking the needle out of the haystack by taking models we have of what the signal should look like and matching that against the data.
We're part of a worldwide network of gravitational wave detectors, and we all work together as a team and gather the data together and analyze the data together. We are only now beginning to hear the vibrations of space-time that are all around us. We just needed a better ear. And when we detect that, we're detecting the vibrations of everything that has ever moved in the universe. This is real. This is really there, and we've never noticed it until now.